Hello and welcome to the Sarah Living Life YouTube channel. I'm Sarah and this is a YouTube channel that's all about what life with a disability could look like. Yay! So here I am on spring break, which is really exciting from school. Travel bans started to get lifted in the state of Pennsylvania, so I was able to use my flight benefits and hop out on a plane up to Phoenix, Arizona. My sister was able to fly out as well, and we've been spending the week with my parents here, which has been really fun. I do want to share that one fun thing that we did get to do, which I had never been to before, was going to go see the Grand Canyon. So Madeline and I and my parents all made the trek. We took the scenic route up to Grand Canyon, and then we spent a day and a half there. We slept over, and then we got to explore the Grand Canyon. So I'm excited to adventure with you and share with you what we saw.
Auxiliary cord. Do we have all that?
We are all here together in Arizona, and we are reminiscing our childhood by being in the back seat. Although we have grown up, we are no longer fighting over who's sleeping in the middle of the space thing with the armrest.
No man's land.
We're both appropriately putting in our elbows. We have a good elbow shared space here, which is kind of nice. I'm proud of us. So.
Yes.
That's awesome.
We have our snacks, we're all good to go. I guess the only thing we're missing is like our covering.
All right, we made it! We're at the Grand Canyon! This is day two of Grand Canyon. It is 10:49. Oh, we are sitting in the car in this very long line. Do you see all these people behind us? How far away are we from the Grand Canyon entrance, Pops?
2-3 miles.
Ooh. Okay, so this is 2-3 miles of just
of everybody waiting to get in. This is the line.
This is the line. We're in the line. Beginning the trailhead of the Bright Angel Trail, and this will take you all the way down to the bottom of the Grand Canyon, which we will not be doing, but we're doing like a little taste of it just to sort of get a feel. So come join us. All in all, the Grand Canyon was pretty incredible. It was very striking to see all of the colors, all of sort of the striations of the different types of rocks that have been there, and that this is something that is, you know, billions and billions of billions years old, and just really incredible to be able to be there and look at that. It's something, you know, of course we've learned about and heard about, and I've seen a whole variety of different pictures on, but I had never really gone there and been able to experience it myself. And it is, I mean, absolutely breathtaking to look out on it. Being able to access it, you drive up around the rim, and then it's just, I mean, thousands and thousands of just stretches of beautiful land, which is really cool. It's also terrifying because you can get really close to the rim and then it just drops off into the abyss, which is a little frightening. And you even feel that, like I couldn't get very close to the edge of it, and I could definitely feel the weight of just the immensity of the place that I'm in, which was pretty incredible. I am a person who grew up in sort of a hiking world. I did lots of classes on hiking, and you know, something that we talk a lot about is a commercialization of like natural spaces and sort of what is the impacts that that has on, you know, and then there's the arguments of if you should keep things sort of naturally preserved and only accessible for people who are hikers or engaging in hiking type things and kind of limiting the traffic of it. But then there's this other part of me that is all of the disability advocacy spaces where commercialization means that there's roads and means that there's access and bathrooms and food for people who may not, certainly not be able to access these really beautiful spaces. Supports were not present. So while there's this like nature heart of me that wants to keep natural parks and natural things preserved, there is also this other space where we can make them accessible. So really finding ways on how we can really blend both of those together. And I think some ways is just really respecting the space that we're in and really taking appreciation of the beauty that, while this is a little bit commercial, it still is natural, and making sure to pick up all of the things that we bring in with us and making sure to like honor and respect that we're here in a space that is a naturally created space, and really allowing access for people to be able to experience that, right? So that's something that I did see quite a few people there who were using a lot of different mobility aids, and had things not been paved, had pathways not been paved or roads that would be able to come up right next to the rim, then that would have been pretty significant barriers for them to be able to engage with seeing how beautiful the Grand Canyon is. So all in all, those are my thoughts. I thought it was equally beautiful and stunning as it was terrifying. I'm also just thankful that I was able to be here with my family. It's been several months since I've been able to see them. We don't often get to see that as we live in three different states. But it was nice to be able to hang out and share and giggle over all the silly things that we've done throughout our lives. So if it's something that comes up in your life and something that you're interested in checking out, I would recommend it. I would say it's a good thing to do. All right, so thank you so much for hanging out with me and the Grand Canyon. If you have any questions or comments or what your experience has been at the Grand Canyon, please just let me know. That would be great. Otherwise, you can like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you in 2 weeks. Bye.